Unfortunately, as treasurer of the center, I am better with numbers that have dollar signs in front of them. And I can tell you that we've navigated through some tough times in the past 5 years. I'm happy to be standing in front of you to say that I am now more confident of our possibilities in the years ahead than I have been at any previous time during my stint on the board. It feels good to be here tonight celebrating the center with all of you. As my bio suggests, I have been a person who gets bored easily. So you won't be surprised to hear that I like to spend time moving words as well as numbers around the page. It's traditional when receiving an honor like this to thank the people who've given you the opportunity to be who you are. My wife Deborah is one of those. Also my father, who is after all half the reason I'm here. I'd like to close by reading a poem that honors him, one that speaks to the importance of both words and numbers in my life. It's titled, A Math Man Channeling Plato. It has been too long, I fear, since I sat down to write you. At the desk unused for so long, I cannot remember who might have sat here last. Too long for the words to come as easily as they once did. The desk was my mother's, 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 but she cannot have been the last. And this letter is not about her, whom I never knew, or her daughter, whom I did, or my mother, whose care is now entrusted to me. Nor is it to any of them. It is not about the walnut desk stained dark with its ornately carved legs, or about any of the silver heirlooms, hairbrush, porringer, trowel, displayed on its inlay leather top, that I had to clear away along with other impediments. It's about you, Father, gone these 2 years. Writing you is, in a sense, the same as writing myself. So many things the same about us. But unlike me, you did not write, except for your many textbooks. No poems or stories or essays, as far as I know. As I dive back into these waters, these waves of words crashing over me, less a sheer, continuous, indivisible wall and a jumble of phrases, a mess to be disentangled and tied to the page in neat knots, the inevitable pentimento, poem painted over poem. Yes, as I plunge back in, it is those matches I remember. Not the ones to pair this with that, like me with you, but the matches you struck to ignite a fire in my brain. The ones you scratched against a wall in an airless cave, at a time when shadows caused me so little consternation. Back when I was only a boy, guided mostly by imagination, not the reality of a barbarous world. On long walks, you challenged me with puzzles, conundrums that were math problems, cloaked in words to obfuscate a distillation into the known and unknown. What could be seen clearly and what remained concealed, begging to be extracted. Numbers drawn out of words, then shapes from numbers, sketched in lines that broke clear through the stone, into fresh air, and up into the ozone. Then geometry from those lines, the perfect symbols for air, earth, water, fire. It was words on their own, only after numbers mixed with words, then numbers alone. Words became flames at the tip of my pen, as if phrases must be ablaze if they are to mean more than merely be. Words to expose the meaning of shadows in this world, often impossible to fathom until my mind seizes them and holds me for a ransom I think I cannot pay, and cannot pay, until I wholly forsake numbers in favor of words again. Genuflect before the altar of words, arranging themselves into lines that yearn to me. Lines whose will I force to bend at the knees, like surf walking up a breakwater until it breaks. until I impose constraints to contain the spouting madman I am. So, Father, what I wanted to write you about was yesterday, at your grave where I remembered those boyhood walks at your side. And though I found words 2 years ago as I placed your ashes into the ground, yesterday it was matches. Six arranged into four triangles that lit my recollection. A burning tetrahedron with its perfect symmetry from the mind of a mathman. Matches to see you better by now that you're gone. Thank you.